Hi, welcome to How to Repair. Today's tutorial is on how to find the error code on your Beko washing machine. Now, Beko manufacture machines for many companies, which are in the description below. But first thing you need to understand is you have two types of display on a Beko washing machine. You have the LCD display, which is a digital screen which will show you what the function is of the machine and how long it's got left on it. And if an error code is displayed to you, it will normally be on the screen itself showing you E03, E09, E29, depending on what the error is. Some error codes are not displayed to the general public when they're in their wash program. You actually have to go into diagnostic mode. Now, you may think you have a problem with the machine. You would sometimes have to go into diagnostic mode to understand if you do have an error stored in the EEPROM on the machine. The EEPROM is the memory chip. Now, on the LED version, it's a lot more complicated. LED version works on the system of BCD format, which is binary code decimal. This means that all the spin speeds are preset with a value. And when you add up these values, they then determine what the error is. And I'm going to show you on both types how to understand each error code and what they are. Now, I've actually set this machine up with an error already because I've actually created a fault on the machine to show you what the error is. But first, let me explain how this works on the decimal type. Now, on the LED type, you have five spin speed positions. It doesn't matter if you have a 1200 machine, 1400 or 1000 spin speed. There are only five positions on the left-hand side. Each one of these positions has got a preset value attached to it. Now, the 1200 is equivalent value to 16. The 1000 is equivalent value to 8. The 800 is equivalent value to 4. The 600 is equivalent value to 2. And no spin is equivalent value to 1. Now, if you have an error showing at the end of the machine, or if you're in diagnostic mode, there may be one or multiple lights showing when an error code should be displayed. Now, I've set this machine deliberately for you with an error. And let's have a look at the error. I'm just going to enter diagnostic mode. And as you can see here, we have three lights lit up. We have 1000 spin speed lit up, 600 spin speed, and no spin lit up. This means that we have error code 11, because the 1000 is 8, the 600 is 2, and the no spin is 1. Add all those numbers up and they're equivalent to 11, and then prefix it with E11. Now, E11, according to the diagnostic manual, is motor phase open circuit, which means this is related to an error with the motor. Now, the workshop manual then shows you how to rectify this fault. And each one of these errors, as I show you through the video, I will lead you to other videos which will help you rectify the problem with your machine. So let's go to the computer now and let me go through each individual error, whether you have an LCD or you only have an LED type, and I'll show you how to rectify the problem.
Beko actually manufacture for a vast array of companies, which I've listed below. So if you do have a similar type machine from one of these brands, then this video will apply. Now, on the side here, you can see that I've put the BCD values for you for reference purposes all the way through this video. And position 5 has got equivalent value of 16, 4, 8, 3, 4, 2, 2, 1, 1. Now, this will apply to any type of spin speed because normally you only have five positions on the spin speed. Whether you have a 1400 or 1600, it makes no difference. Now, if you have an LCD display type or an analog type, if you go into the diagnostic mode in our other video, if you have an error code when you first go into the diagnostic mode, it will display the error with E, then followed by a number. This will be the error code. On the analog system below, or the LCD version, it will show you different spin lights showing up, and we need to work out what the values are on each one of these to understand what the error is. If there is no error present on either machine, you will either have nothing showing at all on the LCD, or it is possible that you will have E-dash-dash, which means there is no error present. On the analog system or LED version below, there would be no spin lights illuminated. This means that there is no error. All error codes that I list now, you need to understand it may not just be a faulty component. You could have a problem with either a connection on the circuit board or one of the terminals on a component, or possibly a bad wire. This means that metal fatigue may have taken place in the wire. So you need to check the wiring using continuity from the start point to the finish point on the wiring. Error code 1 normally means that your washing machine is washing poorly, taking a long time to wash, or not heating the water. Now, error code 1 is an NTC sensor fault. It can either be a fault with the NTC sensor, the wiring going to the NTC sensor, or possibly an open loop circuit on the circuit board, which means you have a faulty component. Now, on the digital display, it is displayed in the diagnostic mode with E01. On the LED version, which is the top photograph, the no spin symbol will be showing, and this means that it has a value of 1. This then is determined as error code 1. There is another video to assist you in testing this component and how to gain access to the component. Error 2 is to do with the heating system. Your washing machine may not be heating the water. It may not be heating the water after it has tripped the electricity supply because the element may have gone open circuit, or you may have a problem with the relay on the circuit board that controls the heating system. Error code 2 is displayed on the LCD version as E02, but on the LED version, it is the second position on the spin cycle. This now has a value of 2, so we know it is error 2 on the actual diagnostic sequence. There is a video below to show you how to test the element, how to check the wiring, and also to understand what the relay does on the circuit board. Error code 3 is a heater-related fault from the circuit board. This can either be a problem with the heater constantly energized, and you would notice that your clothes are either boiling on a wash cycle, or the clothes may be coming out hot at the end of the cycle. You need to check the circuit board and the heating system. Error code 3 is displayed as E03 on the LCD version, but it's only available in diagnostic mode, the same as the LED version. In the LED version, you will see that position 1 and position 2 lights are illuminated. Therefore, we have a value of 2 plus 1 equals 3, therefore giving us error code E03. There are videos below to assist you in this repair. Error code 4 is to do with the water intake system. The water valve may be defective, or possibly filling all the time because it is energized constantly by the circuit board. You need to actually go into diagnostic mode to actually find this fault. E04 is displayed on the LCD display type. On the LED display type, you will see position 3 is lit up. This equals 4, and therefore you have error code 4. There are videos to assist you on water valve faults in the description below. E5 is normally to do with the pump, or it is unable to empty the water from the machine in the allocated period of time. You may have a restriction in the water flow going to the waste pipe. This could be a blockage in the sump hose, the pump, or the waste pipe fitting if it's connected to a sink. You may also have a problem with the power going to the pump. All these are water related with regards emptying water from the machine. It is displayed on the LCD version as E05, but on the LED version, there will be position 3 and position 1 illuminated. This would mean that you have 4 plus 1 equals 5, and therefore you have error code 5. There are many videos in the description below to assist you with problems with pumps, And there are also many videos on the website to show you problems with sink fittings, waste pipes, and sump hoses. Error code 7 is normally related to the pressure sensor. You will need to check the wiring. You will also need to test the actual pressure sensor. The problem with this is you will need a specialist meter that measures frequency. Error code 7 is displayed on the LCD version as E07, and on the LED display you will have position 1, position 2 and position 3 illuminated. 4 plus 2 plus 1 equals 7, therefore you have error code 7. There is a detailed video on how to test this below. Error code 8 is a simple fault. This is normally to do with a water supply problem to the machine. You may have a kinked pipe going to the machine. You may have no water going to the machine from the tap. Or it is possible that a water valve has gone open circuit and is not working correctly. There are videos below to show you how to replace water valves and how to test the water valve system. Error code 8 is displayed on the LCD display with E08, and on the LED version it shows position 4 illuminated. This has a value of 8, so we have error code 8. Error code 9 is door lock fault or door lock circuit fault. This could either be a problem with the circuit board not energizing the door lock, or the door not activating correctly. Or you may have a problem with the wiring loom. On the LCD version, it is displayed E09, and on the LED version, it is displayed with the fourth and the first lights illuminated. This would be 8 plus 1 equals 9, therefore you have error code 9. There are many videos below and on the website to assist you with all types of door lock problems. If you have a washing machine door that will not open and you go into diagnostic mode and you find out that you have error code 10 displaying, then this is normally a problem with the circuit board energizing the door lock when it shouldn't be. Error code 10 is displayed as E10 in the LCD version, and on the LED version it is position 4 and position 2, which are illuminated, meaning that you have error code 10. There is a video below to assist you in diagnosing the problem and replacing the circuit board. If your washing machine is not spinning, or you have no motor action during a wash cycle, or possibly the drum is acting in a jerky type fashion, then you may have a problem with E11 in the diagnostic mode. E11 relates to either a motor fault, or possibly it may relate to the circuit board that controls the motor, or a wiring connection. I have done a detailed video on this below to assist you in understanding what the problem is and how to rectify it. E11 is always displayed as E11 in the LCD version, but in the LED version there are three lights illuminated. Position 4, position 2 and position 1, which give us a combined value of 11. E13 is a very similar fault to E11. If you have no motor action at all, or the motor is not performing as it normally should do, then you may have a problem with either the communication cables that run from the fascial panel down to the control module that controls the motor, or from there going to the motor. But you also want to check the circuit board that controls the motor. Sometimes these do become faulty and do need replacing. It is worth inspecting for dry joints and also for any bad components on the board. I have done a detailed video below to assist you with this repair. This fault is displayed either as E13, or you will see position 4, position 3 and position 1 illuminated. This means that we have a combined value of 13. Error code 17 isn't actually an error. It's a warning that only comes up in the diagnostic mode to tell engineers that customers are usually using too much soap powder or liquid when actually doing a wash. This would cause excess foaming inside the drum, and possibly some of the sensors would get false readings. E17 is only available in the diagnostic mode and is displayed as E17, or on the LED versions, it is the high spin speed that is illuminated position 5 and the no spin speed that is illuminated position 1. This gives us a combined value of 17. Error code 18 is again an actual warning. This is only there for engineers to be notified that the machine may have had an excess load put into the drum or an imbalanced load. This is displayed as E18 on the LCD version, and on the LED version, it's position 5 and position 2 that gives us a combined value of 18. E29, the manufacturer does not really give much information on this apart from operating voltage out of limit. This means that if you had less than 220 volt to 240 volt or exceeding 220 to 240 volt, therefore it's out of the range of the capability of the circuit board. E29 is displayed as normal. On the LCD type, it'll just show E29, and on the LED display, it illuminates nearly the whole screen. We have position 1, 3, 4, and 5, and if you added all those values together, they become E29. I hope this video helped you in finding the fault with your appliance. In the description below, you will find many Beko videos to assist you in either repairing or replacing components on the machine. This video took me quite a while to put together, so do remember to support the website by buying the parts off us. And if I really did help you, you can always click on the Buy Paul Revere page. At the website, there are many tutorials on many types of different domestic appliance. So if you ever need help with any type of appliance, please remember to mark us down to your favorites and hit the subscribe button. Thanks very much indeed again for watching.